Welcome, lower school friends, to this year's Family Egg Drop. We're so excited that you're here, and here's everything you need to know to make yourself a winner today.
In our daily life, we protect packages and our body every day. For example, when we play hockey, we wear protective equipment to protect our brains and our bodies from contact with the puck and with other people. When we go biking, we wear a helmet and protective gear to make sure our bodies are safe. Helmets are designed with all kinds of protection. Rotation and linear symmetry helps protect our brains when we hit our heads. When we send packages, we also use protection. We use everything from packing peanuts to corrugated cardboard, foam, and air pockets to protect our packages. In disaster areas, it's important to get materials to the site quickly and safely. There are now high-tech drones that can deliver this packaging to those areas. In addition, we can do airdrops of materials and safety supplies and food into the disaster area so that people can get their needed supplies right away. That's what you'll be doing tonight. You'll be creating a safe package to deliver an egg through an airdrop.
This all sounds like so much fun, but what is the science that I need to know? What is potential energy and what is kinetic energy? And how does that help me land my egg without it cracking?
Let's talk about the science behind landing with an uncracked egg.
So at the start of your drop, your egg is up high and it's stationary, so it has potential energy, which is the energy associated with height. So these red blocks represent the potential energy. And the higher I go, the more blocks of energy I start with. And then as the egg falls, that potential energy is converted to kinetic energy, which is the energy of speed. So you start up high and every single block is over here as potential energy. But as you start to fall and fall faster and faster, every single block comes over here as kinetic energy or speed. And now your egg is about to impact the ground and has all this energy in the form of speed that's got to go somewhere. Now this broom represents the standing energy that holds an eggshell together and makes it hard. So the way to think about this is when your egg hits the ground, if you introduce more energy than the binding energy of the molecules holding the hard eggshell together at any point, you're going to break at that point. So the question then becomes, what can we do to keep our blocks below the broom? Because simply put, below the broom, your egg is safe. Anything above the broom and your egg is busted. Well, there's two things we can do. The first is that we can make this pile of green blocks not as tall. The second thing you can do is not to remove any green blocks by reducing your speed, but to spread them out. So if we say left to right is our time axis, the more we can stretch out this impact event, the more we can lower that high energy spike. And this is a cool way to think about any two objects impacting. The longer the duration of the impact, the more you can spread out that force so stuff doesn't break. So for example, this is the point of car airbags. Instead of your head hitting the steering wheel and stopping near instantaneously, it stretches out the impact force over time so you don't get a quick spike that exceeds the broom line for your skull. This is exactly why long jumpers prefer to land in sand and not on asphalt, and why parkour runners will always roll after a big jump. It's all about diffusing the force over a longer period of time. So what does that mean for our egg contraptions? It's really just something to keep in mind because it can make it more intuitive, for example, to see why putting your egg in the middle of a jar of peanut butter, which is a popular and not a very good idea, isn't as good as putting your egg in the middle of a popcorn ball. Okay.
Here's what you need to know about tonight's egg drop. You and your family will form a team. You will be given 150 shkalim to purchase materials at our store. While you're working, use the engineering process shown on the image behind me to follow the steps and create a design and continually improve and revise it to make it the best it can be. Your goal is to make small packaging, light packaging, and cheap packaging so that we can get the most materials to where they need to be.
When you're planning for your design, take into account what materials are going to be available to you. Also, remember that we are trying to save money in our designs and want to make the least expensive design. Visit the store as many times as you'd like until you run out of money. But be careful, leftover money will count towards points on your score sheet. Also keep in mind, our store does not accept returns.
Fill out the score sheet while you go to keep track of everything you do. Since we know you're going to be a great team, we've already given you 500 points for your teamwork. Don't forget to use the engineering process 300 points are awarded to teams who follow that process. Around the room, you'll see signs like this one. Find the volume. These are things you'll need to do in order to complete your score sheet. The volume will be calculated to ensure that you use the smallest design. Find the drop sites around the room to try out your design. If your egg passes, give yourself points for that drop. If not, try again. Revise your design. What changes do you need to make so that it will survive the drop? Work up until you get to the highest drop at 7 feet inside.
When you've revised your package and it survives all of the drops inside of the cafeteria, you'll submit yours for our championship drop in the auditorium.
Ahatzlacha and good luck.